So, Digimon has a ban list. And we're gonna talk about it. Hey guys, Joshua Boosters here. Welcome back to another Digimon video. Actually, really short on time today, but I really thought this was something super interesting for the card game that I really want to talk about. So, I didn't really have enough time to actually prepare like the format for this video, so I'm just gonna kinda talk as we go and see how it turns out. But yeah, today on the 12th of February, they actually announced the very first Digimon ban list. This has been a source of a little bit of speculation for the player base because there's been some discussions basically whether they, you know, people thought the game would have set rotation or they would eventually go for a ban list. You know, set rotation like in Pokemon and a ban list like in Yu-Gi-Oh, for example. But it seems they actually decided to go for the ban list, and I kind of want to talk about why I think that's a good thing. And you know some other implications this has for the game. But first, let's actually look at the announcement, which I do have here. Basically, the site states right now, in the Digimon card game, your deck can include up to 4 copies of a card with the same card number. This is actually misspelled, so that's kind of funny. But yeah, in official tournaments, however, some cards are banned or restricted, limiting the number of copies you can play. Banned cards cannot be included in decks. For now, there's actually no banned cards. And then there's restricted cards, then in brackets a 1. If you want to include cards listed as restricted, you can only include a number of copies equal to the number listed in parentheses. So, for now there's actually only 2 cards that are on the list, and both of them are restricted to 1. And then it says, based on the current competitive environment, the following cards will be added to the banned and restricted list as of April 1st, 2021. And these cards will be Argomon, the level 5. The one that has the download ability. And then, arguably, the best card in the game, Hidden Potential Discovered. So, both green cards. And you know, in my opinion, this makes a lot of sense. Because green has been basically the best deck for a while in the Japanese card game, basically. And then, also what I like is that they actually give like a little bit of an explanation as to why they actually hit these cards. Like, I'm just gonna show you the screen, so you can read it yourself. But I think that's really good. Like in Yu-Gi-Oh, for example, they don't really give any explanation why you know they made some decisions. But here they actually give like a little bit of that, which is very good. And then it says banned cards. There are currently no banned cards. So yeah, and that is the ban list. Now I definitely think this is a good thing, right? This definitely shows they are willing to delve into the competitive format and make sure the game is healthy, basically. They want to see a lot of variety in the decks. They don't only want to see people playing green in this case, which I definitely think is very good. I also think the hits themselves are, I mean, Hidden Potential Discovered is obviously just the most broken card in the game. I definitely think hitting that to 1 was correct. Then on Argomon, I'm not so sure. It's a little bit iffy for me. You know, it's probably because, you know, you have both Argomon and Blossomon for the level 5 green download Digimon. But still, I'm not 100% sure if this was really necessary and, you know, in what way this will actually have an influence on the green deck going forward. I definitely still think green is one of the very best colors in the game. They have a lot of very broken supports, so it will probably still be competitive. But yet, definitely a good decision on their part to create this ban list. What I think is interesting is that it's currently also on the English side, so this will probably mean we are actually also getting these changes to the list on April 1st, which I think is very good actually, because you know, the English game actually has a glance into the future by looking at the Japanese format, and by that we can actually prevent getting into a still format like they are. I'm not saying the format right now is still by any means, like purple, yellow, green, they're all, you know, really good decks and competitively viable, but I definitely think green was the best one, so this seems like a fair hit. And if Bandai decides to, like it seems right now, implement this on April 1st, we'll have like, I think less than a month to play with the 1.5 sets, with these cards, you know, unlimited basically. And then after that, we'll just be playing with them being limited. which I think is good. It will definitely make you know, bring some more variety to the format. I myself am like a little bit disappointed because I was really looking forward to green. Green is basically my favorite color in the game. Playstyle wise, I was really looking forward to playing the very broken green machine. But I guess I'll just have a couple of weeks to do that. But yeah, guys, that was basically what I wanted to talk about. The last thing I want to mention is like the difference between a ban list and set rotation. But I definitely prefer a ban list because it means, you know, all the old cards you might want to play, they you know, they remain in the game. I could have definitely seen them doing something like a set rotation, and then, you know, they have to sort of reprint all the vanilla no effect monsters with you know, specific DP and specific play cost and stuff, and then they could, you know, print other Digimon with the same stats as a reprint, basically, which would have been, I mean, fun, I guess, but this way you can just, you know, keep playing your old cards. It's an incentive to keep playing the cards you got from, like, the first set and the second set, because there might actually be cards in there that, you know, are still competitively viable. And then one of the things that's a little bit less good about the ban list format is basically, eventually, you know, there might be old cards that have really broken interactions with new cards, and with set rotation, you know, there's just a little bit of a difference there. And lastly, of course, I just think having a ban list in place is good, because it mostly also shows that Bandai won't just be, you know, drastically power creeping the previous set to make the game balanced, basically, where you just have to print more broken cards, you know, to make up for the broken cards you printed in the past. But instead, they're actually willing to hit the cards you printed previously, so I definitely think that's a very good thing. So yeah, very interesting change for sure, the first announced ban list. I really want to make a video for this and, you know, talk about it to all the 11 people who watch my Digimon videos. But yeah, guys, if you do enjoy content like this, and you make this far into the video, please consider leaving a like, a comment with your own thoughts, and, you know, subscribe if you haven't yet. And with that, I guess I'll see you in the next one. Bye!